And on the job. Hey, Valerie.
Hey, how's it going, Mur? How are things today?
Well, my dog is creating fire hazard, and biscotti are very crummy, and so he's helping clean up around my little streaming desk, but causing a bit of a fire hazard in the process because the room is packed a little too tight. So, here's what happened. Happy day 8 of NaNoWriMo, National Novel Writing Month. I am Burr Lafferty. This is the daily I should be writing show to celebrate NaNoWriMo. Celebrate? I don't know if that's the right verb. What do you think?
Commemorate.
Commemorate? Sure. Okay. And so today I asked Valerie if she'd be on with me, and she said, yeah. And we're trying to find a time because I said I have a webinar at 1. And I came in here and I pulled up the email to get the Zoom link. And the email says, reminder, webinar tomorrow. And I went, well, crap. Oh, well, I was not liking the break to my workflow. So I can just go back to work. And then I watched TikTok for 40 minutes. And it's
Sounds like a
like,
very typical NaNo experience, frankly, so.
yeah, I think it's the, I don't know if it has a word. You're good with knowing the words to things, but it's like you have the next thing on your list, and when it doesn't happen, you're entirely derailed.
Absolutely. This is in my experience, this is a very standard thing that happens. It is, it's hard to be flexible sometimes, especially when you are already so locked into something. It really is like derailing, is you are literally on a train, on a track, heading towards the next station, and then suddenly something just knocks you right off. And like a train, you can't just kind of get up, shake it off, and recover necessarily. You need a lot of effort and manpower potentially to get you back on track.
So, I got some good writing done this morning until the derailment, and I'm still not sure if I'm going to be streaming in -1 minute. So that's something I should probably decide soon, huh?
Might be a good idea.
Yeah. So, how's your Monday going?
My Monday is okay so far. I actually did get up and start writing as well. So I've got some words in the bank. I've not counted how many. At last check, it was 500, but I don't know. That was a little while ago, so I don't think I have too much more than that. But slow and steady, just trying to get the words in where I can and when I can and how I can.
I decided I was going to look at the days where I did not make the 1,666 word count goal, and I would take one of those days and add those missing words onto a day this week. So today I'm writing for day 8 and making up for day 1.
I
That's
think
my new
that's a really cool
plan.
idea, I think, because on the one hand, it can be good to look at whatever your new average is, because NaNo, the website, conveniently will tell you how many words you need to write in order to finish on time. So if you are ahead or behind, that number will rise or fall above or below the 1,667 threshold. But I think that like what you're doing right now, just pegging it explicitly to a day and adding those words on, for some reason that feels more like direct and personal to me. So I think it's a really cool idea.
It just while I was calculating how many words each day needed to have, I did feel a little bit like I was catwaxing and not actually getting work done, but it didn't take that long. I did have 2 days where I exceeded the count, so I don't have to worry about making up for those 2 days. But I think I haven't checked my word count since I started today. But I got some good writing done this morning. I'm doing a psychological thriller for the very first time, and I'm like, well, something violent should happen pretty soon, shouldn't it? And I'm trying to put in romance, and so I'm like, well, they can't fall on each other immediately. So I'm just all sorts of questioning myself. But I'm still writing. I'm still putting words down. Whether they're any good, well, that's anybody's guess.
Yeah, that's definitely the important thing with NaNo is that you're trying to go for a quantity, not quality. And that doesn't work for everyone. Some people really struggle to not self-edit as they go. But that is part of the sort of prompt of this event is you should at least be trying to focus on getting words down and worrying about fixing it later.
Yeah, definitely.
Yep. And working in a new genre is definitely tough because then while you already have in your head kind of a roadmap, it's like the difference between driving to the grocery store that you drive to every week versus driving to another town, which you don't know the way there. And you're trying to figure out, okay, I've got my map here, maybe, on my phone, I've got directions, something, but you're looking for landmarks. You're trying to figure out, like you said, what should come next? Where am I going to turn next? What's the next stop? Oh no, there's a stoplight. That kind of
Yeah.
stuff.
Whoops. Yeah. So, what's your total? Did I ask you that yet?
What is my total? I don't think I updated the website today, but as of last night, it was 14,265.
Nice.
Yeah,
You are
I've
ahead of the
been,
game.
yeah, I one of the tips and tricks, sort of, which it doesn't work for everyone, certainly, but it does work for me. So I try to keep, standing by it. Is in the first week, I push to get as much as possible ahead because I know that it's likely I'm going to fizzle out later. And so over the course of the month, I will always try to meet the daily minimum. But in the first week, especially, I try to get 2,000 a day if I can. I did not succeed every day, but that is my kind of personal goal, just so that I can. Usually, what that means is if you can get about 2,000 a day in the first week, you will end up with one day of extra words that then can be your kind of like floating cheat day or whatever, for whenever you need it. Or it's just words in the bank that you can take out whenever you need them.
Thanksgiving.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's just be honest. I every year, this is the one where I feel the most guilty and hypocritical, is I have multiple suggestions on how to do NaNoWriMo over Thanksgiving. I've never successfully done it. If I had any sort of momentum, it ground to a halt. And I don't even know. Is there anything that you give advice for that? Because I say, like, let your family know what's going on. Try to build up a cushion if you think you need it, or just get up earlier over the holiday and get some down before anybody has any food preparation or family expectations from you. But that doesn't work for me, so.
I mean, those are all the right tips. So, unfortunately,
Oh, damn.
the other tip that potentially I can give, and this is a difficult one, especially in our current pandemic times to execute, but trying to physically remove yourself from the location so that people cannot access you is another one, because chances are, if you're trying to write in your usual place in your house, assuming you have such a thing, then your family's there. They're physically there. They are going to want to grab your attention. They're going to be passing in and out of the room or wandering downstairs, upstairs, next to you, whatever it is that the configuration of your house is. And they are going to ask you questions as they go because there's a lot going on. There's planning and cooking and football.
Yeah.
Is it football time? I don't do the sports as
I
much,
believe
but
so, yeah. I think it's a
yeah.
football game or something.
Blazeball?
It's a bowl
We're in
game.
full blazeball season right now,
We
right?
are in full baseball season,
Yes.
and all of the weird, everything got really weird, and the Tigers suck, so that's kind of sad. But
But yeah, so physically removing yourself from that environment, going to a different place, is another way of giving yourself that space to be able to do some writing that day. And yeah, I mean, just accepting that maybe that day you're not going to hit the word count, and that's okay because it is a holiday, and it is, this is a voluntary event that you're doing for yourself, and you should, do your best at it. But ultimately, family is important, so.
And I think almost Friday feels harder because you're tired from everything you did on Thursday.
Oh sure, yeah, that's a really good lazy day. But that to me is it's a good time to, again, kind of sequester yourself somewhere, wrap yourself in a nice warm blanket, or if you're in the tropics, get a cold beverage, I guess. And park yourself in just a comfortable place and treat the writing as a treat. Treat it as something that is just a sort of relaxing thing you can do sporadically throughout the day, and don't do anything else. Just make that your all day writing day, and that's how you relax that day.
That's brilliant. We're about to lose you in about 10 seconds, and I've just wrote it down to extend this time period, so it shouldn't happen beyond today. Hopefully, I'll see you in a moment.
I'll
Good.
be
Thank you.
back.
If you're wondering what we're talking about, National Novel Writing Month is the challenge where you go and try to do 50,000 words in 30 days, which the joke is I've never won. I'm a professional writer. I have 5 books out professionally. You can buy them at bookstores even. And yeah, I've never won. Yeah, Valerie, that's why I like having Valerie on, because she's a municipal liaison and has done it several times and won. You've won several times, I assume?
Yeah, I have won at this point a lot of times. I definitely did not win my first couple years. I certainly did not. And so I feel like while you can, while part of the reason that we have all these tips and tricks is to help facilitate winning for people just starting the event, I feel like it's also good to kind of temper expectations and know that even if you don't win the first couple times out, or if you don't win the 5th time, 10th time, whatever, it's not a failure on your part. It doesn't mean you're suddenly not a writer, because obviously, Mer, you have an entire career on writing at a slower pace than NaNo, and it doesn't make you not a writer to not do the thing.
And it just really feels like a Girl Scout badge I can't get.
Yeah, no, I feel you. It's tough to have that kind of ambition, that prize that is just dangling out of reach. But I don't know. I feel like this might be your year. I'm going to put that out in the universe.
I don't know.
We shall see what unfolds. But yeah, I mean, it is a really tough month for it. And I think one of the benefits of that is even if you don't win, first of all, any words are good words. But also, you know that you were trying to do this thing in probably the hardest month of the year for you. And, you know, so anything that you accomplish in this month is kind of, you are playing the video game on hard mode, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like that's its own accomplishment.
True. That's true.
Yep.
Yeah, so I'm also worried because I'm trying to do this daily thing and I'm running out of stuff to talk about. I'm just like, I've tried to be clever in the past. I've tried to do, I'm just, last night I just basically got on and said, keep going, little campers. We'll beat that slope together. We got this. And then, So,
I feel like that's a manifestation though of how NaNo goes, frankly. Like that is what happens at the end of the first week, pretty much, is you start to have that sense of you're slowing down, whatever momentum you had is running out. You are losing, not just losing steam, but losing focus, losing maybe a sense of your plot. Like you're if you outlined in advance, then you're starting to feel like, oh no, my outline is crappy and I can't do it. And if you're falling behind, you feel like you're not going to be able to catch up. And so, I mean, the first week is simultaneously the easiest time and the hardest time for people. It's either easy because you are starting out with the enthusiasm that gets you over the daily goal routinely, and then it will start to peter out over the course of the month. Or you start and you're already behind and you feel like you're never going to catch up. And then it's very tempting at that point to kind of admit defeat and move on. Mm-hmm. But maintaining it and just kind of using it again as an excuse for getting more words in the month than you probably would have otherwise, I think is gonna pay off. And then there are always people that'll just pull out 10,000 words in the last day because they persevered, and then they just have this, I don't know, it's like when you're playing a game and you know that you're almost to the end of the level and then you just sit there for 30 minutes and just grind until you get there. So everyone experiences the month in different ways, but there is that sense of that the end of the first week is sort of, it's a milestone. It's you've crossed the threshold if this is the hero's journey.
Yeah, and this is the point where no matter how pumped up we got for NaNoWriMo, that the cold reality of having to write a ton of words is now just on us. And while we can still go to the Discords and, listen to the podcast and the live writes and all that, it's still something you've got to sit down and do yourself.
Yep, exactly.
And that's just, it's difficult. So while you were saying all the smart, awesome things. I got my word count. I'm at like 96. I've written it 3 times. I still forget. Bah. Scrivener's messing up for me.
Scrivener does that sometimes. It can be a little temperamental with the word counts.
Yeah. 9563.
All right. So you're almost at 10K.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm, I had the wrong, I think my target information is not worked out quite that well because, when I write a whole bunch on for the words and then I grab all the words and I copy them and then I paste them into, Scrivener, they may not all be new words. I'm just trying to take this hunk and place it over the older hunk so it all flows together in Scrivener. And Scrivener's like, oh, wow, you just did 5,000 new words. I'm like, no, I was trying to get just, no, that's not right. So if you're looking at the statistics, my manuscript is at 12,133. Oh, if you actually look at the at the file that says the word count at the very bottom in Scrivener, 9363 or 9563. So that's mine. So, what advice do you give people on week two?
So this is the part, like I said, it can be the easiest time to give up because anyone who's behind at this point can feel like it's time to just go. And so I would say to, first of all, keep going. And to do that, usually the initial inertia that you have to overcome to get started is the hardest thing. And so either scheduling when you are going to do your sprints is a good option. And you may need to revisit whatever schedule you started with in the first week because it may not have worked out. Add one extra sprint a day somewhere, either at the beginning of the day or at the end of the day.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah, just one. Just that one. Because a lot of times if you and if you add it in the morning, the benefit can be, it doesn't work for everybody, but the benefit can be that it helps you as an icebreaker. And you're kind of just, you're clearing the muck off the well, so to speak. You're mm-hmm. you know, scooping the pool sort of thing. So that then you're going to be able to write faster later. Another option is with that first sprint, just writing a summary of what you want to write that day. And so mm-hmm. you are doing a little outlining. Just a little. And that also, it helps you focus. It helps you get organized so that you know what you're doing instead of sitting down and experiencing choice paralysis when you get to your first sprint, because you already know what you're going to do. So that's a couple of things. And, if you can add an extra sprint at the end of the night too, it just wherever you can sneak them in, basically, if you are working in sprints and you're that kind of person that doesn't have to get into the flow state, or even if you are, like I said, just a 10-minute something to just get a few words in, it will add up. And so the more that you can do a little at a time, the better off that you'll be. Also, revisit your reward system. People may not be rewarding themselves consistently for doing the writing thing. And mm-hmm. I find that that can also help overcome inertia. If you focus on, okay, when I sit down to write, I'm going to give myself like a yummy beverage or a cookie or something. And then when I finish, I get some other treat, a TV episode, video games, something, just so that you have not just something to incentivize you to start, but also to motivate you to finish.
Awesome. Well, we are almost at the second 10-minute point, so I think we can probably cut off now, but why don't you tell us where to find you online?
All right. You can find me at ValerieValdes.com. That is Valdes with an S, not a Z. I'm also at Valerie Valdes on Twitter. And this week we have the 100 Hours of Writing Streamathon on Twitch. So you can find me on Twitch at The Kids Are Asleep, which is when I tend to stream. Although my stream slot for that is at noon on Friday.
Oh, Eastern. No.
Yeah. The kids will be awake.
Yeah. All right. And I am Mer Lafferty, merverse.com. I'm here on Wisdom at least once a day talking about NaNoWriMo, at least until NaNoWriMo's over. So thank you very much, Valerie. And hopefully you'll be able to come back on later this month.
Thank you for having me.